Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I'd like to chat to you about how to shoot few girls at the same time, you know, if you have a group shoot and so on. And I also wanted to share with you my thoughts on the Canon 24-70 2.8 lens that I've been testing for the entire week in London. I think when organizing a shoot like that, preparation is key. I found it really important to look at certain inspirations and especially look at models' poses and see what looks natural and what looks good, because it can really help you on the day to kind of pose the models right and just kind of make it look a bit more consistent. So one thing that I noticed that is very important when you're shooting group shots is to keep the model a similar height. On the day, I didn't realize that one of the models was going to be much shorter than the other two, and it caused a bit of problems with the height and so on, because you don't want her to look much shorter than the other girls, because it doesn't look good for the models and doesn't look for the shots. Because of the unexpected height difference, I decided to keep the two taller girls together and then use the other model for something else. Another thing I find helpful with those kind of shots is to keep models' features quite similar. So let's say if the first model has strong cheekbones and so on, it's better if the other one has similar kind of facial features, as it helps kind of make the shoot look more consistent. I also find it helpful if both models are from the same agency, as it helps because the agency will be more prone to post those photos on their page and social media. So when posing the models, try and keep them as close as possible, maybe have their heads kind of leaning towards each other, make sure that there isn't too many empty spaces between their shoulders and stuff. You do want them to look like they're quite friendly and they know each other quite well. It's kind of like the sister kind of feeling where, you know, you're just very comfortable around each other and so on, and if you create too many empty spaces, it's just going to look very awkward and very posed. When posing the models, you also have to keep in mind what f you're using. If you are going quite shallow with your depth of field, you're going to end up having girls out of focus and so on. So it's important to kind of find the middle ground where the models are sharp enough, but you still get the nice bokeh that you want. It can also help if you pose the models the right way, if you put their heads close together at the same kind of level, because this way it's easier for you to find the kind of sharpness. I shot the majority of my shots at around f4. I also went down to f3.2 and up to around 6.3. I kept my ISO at around 200 to 400, depending on the light. During the shoot, the weather was quite overcast. There was loads of really unwanted highlights and shadows that didn't really do anything for the models' faces. So afterwards, I went into Lightroom and I darkened the highlights and I lightened the shadows just to kind of play with a more even kind of look on their faces, and I think it worked quite well.
So far I tested the lens in a variety of kind of surroundings and settings. I shot at night, you know, in Chinatown where it was really, really dark and we had neon lights. I'm testing it now in the kind of really overcast weather. I have to say I really, really love how versatile it is. I love the fact that you can go really wide with it and then you can go up to 70 and, you know, take some photos, like really, really lovely portraits. So I feel like it's a very expensive lens, but at the same time, you can kind of almost get away with only buying this one and nothing else. It's f2.8, which is okay. If you want the kind of like real bokeh kind of look, it is obviously better to go lower, to go maybe like 51.2 or something, which is kind of a similar price point as far as I know. But I think for a starting up fashion photographer, it's an amazing lens to have. And I think if I did my research properly, I would have definitely just bought that instead of the other lenses that I have. So I think if I was to recommend a starting kit for a fashion photographer, it would definitely be the 24-70 and the 100mm macro, because it kind of covers you in all settings and, you know, setups that you need. So you have the 24-70 for any kind of high fashion shoots and model tests and all that kind of stuff, because you have, you know, the lovely 50mm in it and 70, so for like closer portraits. And then you can go for 100mm macro, which kind of covers you in an event of a beauty shoot or anything like that, or if you want like super tight portraits. So definitely both of those lens are absolute winner when it comes to setup. And as I said, if I was a bit smarter, and even though I was buying this stuff last year, I wish I did the proper research and I invested in those two lenses instead.
Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time. The trees will bloom and I